faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle.
Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind.
But then one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold.
Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away.
But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within.
And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress.
The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart.
As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there.
Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world.
The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years.
If he could learn to love another and earn her love in return, by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken.
If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time.
As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope.
For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Expensive.
There must be more than.
attention to more important things.
Hint, hint, like you. The song, please. I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool. He needs all the help he can get.
Oh, dear. castle.
I lost my way in the woods.
Not welcome.
I'm sorry, Arnold. Just be going.
It's hideous, isn't it? To stare at the beast. Haven't you?
No! I meant no harm! I was merely looking for a place to stay!
Why is it for a place to stay?
Listen, you must leave this place!
I won't leave you!
should not have trespassed here.
But he's an old man. He could die.
There's nothing you can do.
Wait. Please. Take me instead.
No, no. You don't know what you're doing.
You would do that. You would take his place.
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes. But you must promise to stay here with me. Forever.
No!
Come closer.
Belle, you don't know what you're doing. I'm an old man. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done. Take him to the village.
No! No, wait, please, not yet!
Let her go! Let her go!
Mama! I'll never see him again, and I didn't even get to say goodbye.
Master, considering the girl will be staying with us for quite some time, you might want to offer her here a more comfortable room.
I'll show you to your room. You follow me! This will be your home now. You're free to go wherever you like, except the West Wing.
Why?
It's forbidden. You've never set foot there. Do you understand?
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah.
beast! A horrible, monstrous beast! All right, I'll go back there and get him myself!
Crazy old
down. If the master finds out, it'll be our next.
Of course, of course. But what is dinner without dance to music? Music! You must be mademoiselle. It is within this power and greatest penalty that we reckon here tonight. And now, I want you to relax and let us pull out the gel as the dining room is crowded for mates. Your dinner. Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our serves before us. I am dying from the neck to give you my best. To the door of the girl who I'll be on the fifth floor.
It's delicious.
Don't leave me out to the kitchen.
Quick thinking on my part. The disaster was averted.
What's over there?
Nothing. at all of any interest in West Wing.
So that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding there.
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. Right this way, we have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to... Don't touch that!
I'm sorry!
What are you doing in here?
I
told you never to come here!
I know, but...
Do you realize what you could have done? Get out!
Ah, don't touch me!
I didn't...
Promise or no promise, I won't stay in this castle!
I'm sorry! I didn't mean to frighten you! You don't understand. There's so little left of me. So little left.
Belle ran into the forest as fast as she could.
Night was falling and the storm was approaching and it was getting hard to see.
When she stopped to catch her breath, Belle heard a low and menacing growl of wolves.
One wolf charged Belle head on and she grabbed a branch to defend herself.
Suddenly, the beast leapt out of nowhere and pulled the wolves off of Belle.
Belle took cover as the wolves turned and attacked the beast.
One grabbed hold of the beast's forearm, wounding him.
The beast struggled to stay on its feet.
Once the beast hurled the last wolf away, he collapsed, exhausted and in pain.
Belle knew that this was her chance to get away, to go home.
But as she looked at the beast, that hideous creature who saved her life, she could not leave.
Belle approached the beast and helped him to his feet.
Then Belle and the beast slowly made their way back to the castle.
Excellent.
I haven't felt this way, Hunter. I want to give her something. But what?
It has to
something special, something that sparks your interest.
Look who's back.
Say something about her hair.
It's brown. What a nice bow.
Thank you.
Well, I want to show you something. First, you must close your eyes. It's a surprise.
Human again. Yes. Secrets and limits.
that?
A second chance.
Will you have dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? We mean with you, could it be? I mean, oh yes!
Thank you.
Are you happy?
Oh, yes. Everyone is so kind to Mrs. Potts, Olivier. Yes.
Go! I've never seen that.
Well, Master, I must say, that went just swimmingly.
I let her go.
You what? How could you do that? But why?
After all this time, he's finally learned to love.
Then that should break his spell.
Not enough. She has to love him in return.
And now, it's too late.
Hear him roar, see him! but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead. Let's kill the beast!
You won't let you do this!
Try and stop us.
Oh, Papa, it's all my fault. I have to go back and warn him.
I'll come with you.
No!
I lost you once before. I'm not going to lose you again.
We'll rid the village of this monster. Who's with me?
We are where we shall be. aren't you handsome?
My mate, you look so much better.
Olivier, you look so much better this way.
Madam, may I say, you look ravishing.
Why, thank you, Cogsworth. I still can't believe this just fits me after all this time. Mama! Mama! Chips, I see it right here.
Are they going to live happily ever after, Mama?
Of course, my dear.
just a fun labor of love to do. So, so excited. We have to do our awards. We're so excited. We have quite a few, because as you can see, we've got quite a few of our older dancers in this recital. We're going to start with our five-year awards. First, we have a five-year award for Lily Calvert. We have a five-year award for Anna Berthelsen. Anna's been waiting to get that trophy. We have a six-year award for Layla De Los Santos. A six-year award for Mia Guillen. Come stand in line. Layla, come stand in line. We want to see how many of them we have when we get them all lined up. We have a... We have a six-year award for Ashton Hughes. We have a six-year award for Sarah Miller. We have a seven-year award for Senior Bailey Awolt. We have an eight-year award for Haley Daniels. We have another eight-year award for Amanda Daniels. We have a nine-year award for Chloe Baker. Graceful dancer that she is. For our 10-year awards, we get the girls get a Station School of Dance pendant. It is my logo dancer in a heart that is specially made and was custom designed for our studio. And we have a 10-year award to give in this recital. And this goes to Gabby Vasquez. And because we have the older kids here today, we've got a lot of pendants that got new stones in them this year. So we have an 11-year pendant, which has a birthstone in it for Katie Smith. We have 12-year awards. The first year they get their birthstone, and the second year they get my birthstone. So this 12-year award goes to Kayla Woodson. Our next 12-year award goes to Adair Collins Johnson. And our last 12-year award goes to Jackie Reiniga. Okay, we have a 13-year award. For 13 years, we add a ruby for the love of dance. And this 13-year award is for Michaela Hansen. We have two 14-year awards, and they get sapphires this year. That's because sapphires are for loyalty. So the first 14-year award goes to Lauren Hassel. And our last 14-year award goes to McKenna Woodland. Along with our milestone awards, which those are, y'all can take a seat. Thank you, girls. Great job. Isn't that amazing that we've had this many kids? And that line has been that long every award show today. And I think how often our children don't stick with anything. And we don't learn to be good at anything if we don't stick with it. So I'm very proud of those numbers every time. That's really an accomplishment for them to have stuck with anything this long. I think that's fantastic. Besides our, we have some other awards to give, but I need to do a few little quick thank yous. We want to thank Mountain View College for hosting us and Kurt Stiles. Please run our lights up there. We appreciate them. We appreciate this facility. It's a beautiful facility. We want to thank Family Music Theater from Cedar Valley College. We borrowed a few of our props and our set pieces from them. They were happy to oblige us. And we also got to use, we rented their microphones because they have a lot of wireless mics. So we want to say thank you very much to FMT. We rented our costumes for our main characters from Costumes by Dusty. If you ever need a great Halloween costume, they've got all sorts of crazy stuff. You can be Mrs. Potts next year. I know you're dying to do it. And then I want to thank the parents who helped out with the work days, and especially the last week. I have had some parents who have been at the studio every day after work until I was done at 9 or 9:30 at night, and I want to thank all of them. I want to especially thank Sharon Barton, Elaine Stitton, the Hayeses, the Lees for their sewing, Karen Baker, beautiful painting for us, Kelly Blackburn, who did every little thing imaginable, and I want to thank Chris Clark and Johnny Lee and my father-in-law for loading our 26-foot trailer to get all this stuff over here. And I want to thank, we have a backstage crew. We have David Johns, our stage manager, but we have Chris and Courtney and Zachary Clark. They've all been working all day long just because their mama said, please. So we so appreciate that. And I want to introduce my assistant teacher. Lauren is my ballet teacher this year, and she's been helping out all day long and has made my spring go very smoothly, so I appreciate her so much. We've got a few more awards, and these are ones that they've been waiting for. I'm giving a best technique and a most improved in my level one class that's here tonight. My best technique, and this is done by their report cards, by the one with the most, you know, the highest scores on their report cards, and you parents all saw those report cards, so you know we test a lot of steps. So my level one best technique is Sarah Miller. And my most improved, stand right up there, Sarah. Just wait for the other girl to come up. My most improved in my level one group this year just worked like a demon. And she's just the most sunshiny child that I have ever known. She always has a smile on her face. This goes to Riley Clark. And last but not least, every year I give a scholarship at the studio. If you were here earlier today, I give, today we had a corporate scholarship. We had a company that decided they wanted to sponsor a dancer for next year. And we gave that one in the 12:30 award show because it I chose someone that was not in this show. So we gave it to the 12:30 award to Cadence Bumgartner. She's a second grader, and it's for a year's worth of dance. It was a corporate sponsorship. But this is my personal scholarship. When I started my studio 26 years ago, my very first teaching job was for Texie Waterman, the lady that started the Dallas Cowboy Cheerleaders. And I taught for her, and at her recital every year, she gave a scholarship. And I had never seen that done before, and I thought, what a wonderful thing. And when I set the guidelines for my scholarship, it's not about need, and it's not about the best dancer. It's about the one that shows the same kind of passion that I have for my job, even after 26 years of teaching. I still love what I do. And so it's that passion that I'm looking for in my scholarship student. So my scholarship student, Ms. Lauren, was a scholarship student. As a matter of fact, if you've been a college scholarship student, stand up. And I have some in the audience, girls. Hey, can I have all my alumni stand up? I got a bunch of alumni here. Where are y'all? Haley and Taylor are here, and Sarah and Rachel. Rachel and Sarah graduated 2 years ago. Haley and Taylor graduated 4 years ago, and they were all happy to see them. So, and we've got some scholarship students standing at the, on the stage. So we're passing our new scholarship student to Janelle Baker. Janelle
is in the company, and she is a second year dancer. And if you saw her, you'd think she's a dancer forever. That's passion, and that's hard work. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna take the three. Sorry, I guess we're not gonna do what I thought we were gonna do. Y'all saw Bailey A. Walton. These are this year's three graduating seniors.